This is my sixth episode in a series for the 5-hour school week that I'm doing called I Want to Homeschool But. And I get this one all the time. I want to homeschool, but I'm afraid it costs too much money. Let's just jump right in. And I just want to say, absolutely untrue. Homeschooling really doesn't have to cost a thing. And when you compare it to the cost of supplies, the commute to and from school, the lunches that you're paying for, I swear it's going to even out. In our book, The 5-Hour School Week, I talk in detail about the importance of becoming a tourist in your own city. What do you have near you? Parks, state parks, national parks, museums, children's museums, science museums, history museums. Is there something an hour away? What about in each direction an hour? Find bodies of water, lakes and rivers, nature trails and forests are all really great places for awesome free learning experiences. Libraries are completely free and we spend tons of time there. You do not need to invest in buying your children new books every time they read something or when you're looking something up. It's completely up to you how much money you want to spend on curriculum. We spend $10 a month per student on time for learning, and it's worth every penny. They keep it organized so that the kids can just flip through and learn exactly what they want to. But there are programs that are completely free of charge, and they are amazing. Look at Khan Academy. You can seriously go from preschool through like getting a bachelor's degree in college with the amount of information that's on that site. There's Adaptive Mind and education.com, and everything is literally like just type it into Google and the worksheets are there, the videos are there, the instruction is there, and it doesn't have to cost you anything at all. And I know everybody has an opinion about YouTube, but you guys, there is a video for everything on here. No matter what your kid wants to learn, it is a click away and it is free. I also think that it's incredibly important to be creative. Look for other families that are doing what you're doing. Trade supplies, curriculum, materials. Work together on stuff to cut down costs. If you're gonna go on a road trip, then carpool to save some money. Something else I really feel like you should look into is what does your state provide? I'm going to include a link down below and that goes state by state, but like California has a stipend for homeschool students if you belong to certain charters. When I looked over the link that is posted below, it was very specific to which states offer which sort of stipends, how much those stipends are, in which charters or online schools you need to belong to receive those stipends. What's amazing about these programs is they will pay for any extra curriculum materials and often extracurricular activities. The ones that we have here locally in California pay for dance classes, karate, there's even a CrossFit for homeschoolers that this program will cover and pay the entire costs. So we don't personally use a program like that, but I have coached and talked to several people that do, and it has been a huge benefit. I also really want to say this because it's incredibly important to me. Don't compare yourself to other homeschool, unschool, or world school families. I know that's so much easier said than done, but you guys, we're all on a different journey. And I know families of 6 and 7 and 8 children and 1 income. I had a lady, blew my mind, a single mama who's homeschooling her kids on her only income. What you see today, our family traveling the globe with our 4 kids, it hasn't been like this for us always.
In 2009, my second daughter was born 6 weeks early. At the time, I was working my 68 hours a week, and I was barely getting by, and my wife was working nights as a waitress at the casino. And my daughter was born, and I was looking at her in the incubator, and I felt like that was my fault, right? If my wife hadn't been working late nights, this wouldn't be happening. So that was the moment that I had that I quit my job and decided I was gonna go try a new business. And about a 12-month period between about 2013, 2014, we lost it all. And by the end of the year, I was $300,000 in debt. You know, Kaleena and I, went broke after we said, hey, there's a whole bunch of stuff that we should have done with our life and we didn't. If we get it back, we're gonna live life big. So now we're on the road doing crazy stuff with our kids. And we're tired.
Listen, I know sometimes it can feel overwhelming, but if there is a will, there is always a way. If this is what you want, you can get there. So don't compare your path to anybody else's path. Just create your path and it'll work out, because really, learning happens in the everyday. There is so much education in your children just witnessing you making it work. I hope you find this encouraging. If so, please follow along with the 5-Hour School Week on Facebook and Instagram. If I can offer you any more support, go ahead and email me at Kaleena@5hourschoolweek.com and go sign up for our newsletter at www.5hourschoolweek.com. Bye.